This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about prime factorization. But to start with, I want to go over some of the terminology that I'm going to use. So one way to categorize numbers is to break them down into two groups. We can talk about prime numbers and composite numbers. Now, a prime number is a number that can only be divided evenly by itself and by 1. So for instance, 2 is a prime number. I could only divide it by the number 1 or the number 2. 11 is a prime number. I can only divide it by 1 or 11. 43 would be another prime number. You can only divide it by 1 and 43. Now, there are also composite numbers. So a number like 4 is a composite number. I can divide it by more than just itself and the number 1. I could divide 4 not only by 1 and 4, but also by 2. The number 12 is a composite number. There's a number of numbers I could divide it by. I could divide it by 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Now, each of the numbers that I can divide 12 by is called a factor of 12. Okay? So 12 has these 6 factors. 4 has 3 factors. Another way to talk about prime and composite numbers would be to say that a composite number has more than just 2 factors. Okay, so let's look at factorization. Let's say I have the number 12, and I want to divide it, I want to break it down into some of the factors that I can multiply together to make the 12. So I could say that 12 is a result of multiplying 3 times 4. 3 times 4 equals 12. Now, if I wanted to, I could have also said that 12 is a result of multiplying 2 times 6. 2 times 6 also equals 12. Now, let's go to the 3 times 4 part of it. 3 is a prime number, so it's a prime factor of 12. But 4 is not a prime number. 4 could be factored down, it could be broken down into 2 times 2. So I can take this 3 times 4 and write it as 3 times 2 times 2, and that would equal 12. And then the factors that I used to make the 12 would be prime factors. So this would be a prime factorization of 12. Now let's look at what happened when I did the 2 times 6. I said the 2 times 6 equal 12. 2 is a prime number, but 6 is not. 6 is a composite number. So I'm going to break that down into prime factors. I'm going to break it down into 2 times 3. So now I can say that 2 times 3 equals 12. And that would be a prime factorization of 12 because the numbers I've used are all prime factors. Now look at these two prime factorizations. The numbers are written in different order, but I've really got just exactly the same factors in both of them. I've got 3 times 2 times 2 equals 12, and 2 times 2 times 3 equals 12. So both of these prime factorizations are really the same thing. Now, there's a basic rule in mathematics, in arithmetic, that says that any number, no matter what number you pick, will only have one unique prime factorization. So when we find the prime factorization of a number, that's what we're doing. We're finding the one and only way to break the number down into its prime factors. Okay, so now let's look at a factor tree, which is a way of doing this in a kind of an organized manner. So let's say I want to take the number 300 and break it down into its prime factors. So what I can do is find any two factors that I could multiply together to make the 300. It seems like the obvious thing would be a 3 and a 100. So underneath that 300, I'm going to make two branches. That's why we call this a factorization tree. At the end of one of the branches, I'll write the 3. At the end of the other branch, I'll write 100. Okay, so now I've got two factors. But 100 is not a prime factor. So I want to break 100 down. Now, it seems like an obvious way to break 100 down is into 10 times 10. So I'll add two more branches underneath this 100 and put a 10 and a 10. Now, 10 is not a prime number. It's a composite number. So I want to break 10 down into its prime factors. So 10 is 2 times 5, and 2 is a prime number and 5 is a prime number. I'll do the same thing for the other 10. I have 2 times 5. Now, at the ends of my branches, I've got nothing but prime numbers. So this is the prime factorization. What I'm going to do now is write this in a more orderly manner. I'll start with the lowest factor that I have, which is a 2. I've got 2 of them. So I'm going to write 2 times 2. I'll then go over to the 3. That's the next lowest number I've got as a factor. I've got 1, 3. And then I've got these two 5s. So I've got 2 times 2 times 3 times 5 times 5. If I multiplied all of those together, I would get 300. Now, if I want to do this in a condensed version, I can use exponents. So instead of writing 2 times 2, I'll write 2 squared. The 3 is just a 3 to the first power. I'm not going to bother with an exponent for that. I've got two 5s, so I have 5 squared, and that's going to equal 300. So this is my prime factorization of 300. Now, different people might get to this factorization different ways. Somebody might look at the 300 and say, 300 is even, so I'll divide it into 2 and 150. Then 2 would be prime. They might want to divide the 150 into, 3 and 50. 3 times 50 is 150. 3 is prime, but 50 is not. So I could divide that into 2 times 25. And then the 25 would be broken down into a 5 and a 5. So this tree looks different than the first one I did, but at the ends of each of the branches, I've got exactly the same prime factors. So no matter how you do it, you're going to end up with one unique prime factorization. Okay, and that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.